Have you ever given to a GoFundMe cause? Well, these days, entire TV shows are being crowdfunded with these kind of sites. The Chosen is the largest crowdfunded TV show to date, and it's about the life of Jesus. John and I recently sat down with the man behind the show, Dallas Jenkins. Take a look. Dallas, tell us about The Chosen.
Well, this is a project that came out of a desire to see something that hadn't been done before. There's been movies and miniseries about the life of Christ, but there's never actually been a multi-season show where you can binge watch it with your family, where you can get into the characters and into the stories in a deeper way than is traditional for most Bible projects. Typically, you've got 90 minutes to 2 hours to tell the story of Jesus, and you've got to go from miracle to miracle, Bible verse to Bible verse, and you don't get a chance to really connect with the characters. You're just kind of seeing the stories portrayed onto film. And in a show that you're binge-watching with your family or with your wife or whatever, you're actually getting a chance to explore these characters and these stories over the course of multiple seasons. And so you can take your time more. You can get deeper into it. And so as someone who's been a believer my whole life, who's heard these stories dozens of times, the opportunity to tell the same stories but from a different perspective and in a deeper way was really appealing to me. And it's been proven now to be appealing to the audience as well. So I think they're experiencing what I've experienced as we've been exploring these stories.
Yeah, audience habits have changed to binge watching rather than just, you know,
and creating a universe in which they can see things over the course of time as opposed to fitting it into one quick movie.
Mm-hmm. Well, I understand that your project wasn't easy getting off the ground.
When we went to our audience and said, we want to crowdfund this project and have you be part of the making of it and you be part of the financing of it, and that's going to protect the story and keep it from, you know, the voices that may be antagonistic towards a story like this, we're going to maintain the control. You know, Hollywood's golden rule is he who has the gold makes the rules. And so we're going to make our own rules, and we're going to do this outside the system. And not that, on one hand, that has made things very difficult. I mean, it just takes more time. These systems have been in place for decades, so we're trying to maybe create something new. But on the other hand, it's been joyous because the crowd themselves, I think, trusts us even more because of the fact that we're outside the system.
This is the largest crowdfunding media project ever, is that right?
We ended up getting over $10 million from over 19,000 people, which shattered the all-time crowdfunding record.
Wow.
And I think spoke to the passion that especially believers are having in this country for something that's different, that speaks to them, because they're tired of trying to binge watch. The only shows that they have to binge watch that they can choose from are stuff that doesn't always reflect their values. And so a Jesus show that they can watch like their friends watch other shows, I think, is really exciting for people.
I'm glad you said that, because when you think about the audience, you want a wide audience to watch this.
Sure.
However, you're targeting a niche and relying on a niche audience of believers. Is it difficult to tackle a movie like this about Jesus with people who are familiar with Jesus's life? Is it difficult to take that on?
Yeah, well, you mentioned that we have a niche audience. It's interesting because I think the niche audience is what helped finance this, because they have a spiritual compulsion to see something like this done. But in terms of the audience, it's actually been quite wide.
Yeah.
We hear from atheists and agnostics all the time who feel like this is a show that they can appreciate as well, because it feels like a regular show. It doesn't feel like a sermon put into a visual category. It feels like the kind of show that they would normally watch. And that's what's cool. Even our actors and some of our crew members who didn't come onto the project as believers have loved the script so much, it's opened them up to wanting to see more from the scriptures. It's opened them up to wanting to know more about who they're portraying. And that's been one of the most exciting things about this project, is to see people, including those who are working on the show, be exposed to Christ in a way that doesn't feel like it's formula. It doesn't feel emotionally distant, which I think, whether it's, you know, growing up in Sunday school with the flannograph Jesus, mm-hmm. doesn't always feel authentic, or watching a movie where it's very reverent and stiff and formal and Jesus is a European white guy who speaks in King James English. This is something that we're really going for, more authenticity, something that feels raw and real, and that has, you know, which shouldn't surprise us as believers, that has appealed to a wide group of people, because the message of the Gospels is one for everybody.
And you can watch the first season of the show for free by downloading the app. Just search The Chosen in the App Store.